Welcome back to our video series. I'm Dave Sulcer at BMC Software. This is the fourth video out of five in the series of building an application. We are still in the implementation phase, but we've deployed our code and we're ready to consume it in Innovation Studio. So let's bring up Innovation Studio. Now, one thing I'm going to show here is not the only way to use Innovation Studio, but in order to use the code in the library I just deployed, I'm going to create a new bundle, which is going to be a codeless application. That way, I can keep my application that I create codelessly separate from the code in the library. So we'll use the new button here to create a new application. I'm just going to give it a simple name for now. Now I should have a new application that's completely codeless, and it already exists. It has no definitions in it. Now, one thing I might notice is if I go into the view designer for this application, I can start putting view components into the palette. If you've done the basic tutorial, you're very familiar with this process. I'm just going to create a view here, and I'm going to call it assigned people. I'm going to add a grid component and configure it to show people from my foundation. This is really just to represent some view that you create codelessly. And just for fun, I'm going to put the full name of the employee here in the grid. And move it up to the first position, or near the first position. Okay. Now what I'd like to do is use some of the custom code that I built, compiled, and deployed in the last video. You notice that it shows up here under meal program, because that's what the config.js for this view component said. It had one property, and you notice in the code here, in the config, it declares the name of the property. Now in view designer, I need to take this property and populate it with an expression. I'm going to go into the grid and find the expression for full name and use that as the expression, the value of the label to pass into this component. In fact, I'm going to create an expression that has some constant string in there as well. I have to give my view a name. Now I should be ready to try out my view. I'm going to quickly integrate it to the navigation of the application. Just create a call assignments. Specify the view. Now I can visit the deployed application and try it out. And you notice our custom view component is picking up that expression for full name, and our JavaScript is correctly expanding that in the directive inside our JavaScript code. But what about our Java code? Let's go back in Eclipse and take a look at the project we have there. Under our Java source, there's quite a few packages. In the bundle class, you'll notice that we register a service called meal order service. Its implementation is in the business info folder. This is the interface for it. One of the methods in the interface is getMealOrder. If we look at how that's implemented, notice that there's an @action directive there. This is how the code in the service can be automatically bound in Process Designer to show up as a custom activity. Let's take a look. In our application, bring up Process Designer. Make sure you refresh the browser if you've just deployed your code. So the palette will now has that action showing up as an activity, get meal order, and the input parameter for it, meal order ID, is exactly what was annotated in our Java code. So when this runs, it will actually call this Java code at runtime. Of course, there are many other ways to write Java code and services that can be accessed by your client, and many ways to test them. Here we have a custom REST API that you build that uses the service to return information in JSON. Whenever you're using a HTTP tool with Innovation Suite, you always need to send a login command and get an authentication token into your session. When we look at the actual command, this is actually the REST API that we just saw the code for. It requires a parameter of an order ID of a certain type of record definition. We can get that using Innovation Studio. It has an edit data function. I can just bring up one of the records and get a valid order ID for it. In my tool, I can just complete the URL with the correct parameter. The HTTP GET returns a serialized object in JSON form, but this is actually just exactly what my Java code is doing, and I could have similarly programmed any kind of REST API or custom code. Now you can try this yourself. Create a simple app like I did, or use an existing one. You can have a try out a custom view component. You can build a custom activity in the process, or build a custom REST API as I did. A lot more details in the documentation. Stay tuned for the final video in our series for packaging and providing the bundle when you're done. To find out more, as always, check out developers.bmc.com.